Hello, this is Thea Maria Carlson. I'm Executive Director of the Biodynamic Association, and I'm here today with Çaca Yvaire, who will be one of our keynote speakers at the 2019 Biodynamic Conference. Welcome, Çaca.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for taking some time to talk with me. So could you start by just telling us a little bit about yourself and your work in the world?
Yes, I can. So I'm Çaca Yvaire, and I find myself in the work in the world primarily as a land sovereignty and climate response strategist. Currently, I'm involved with the Northeast Farmers of Color Land Trust Project as a co-director with Stephanie Morningstar. I run a small design firm renegotiating and redesigning migration, sovereignty, and sentience called Ruined Craft when I'm not working on land trusts.
Great. And how did you get into that work?
Yeah, I mean, that's a wonderful question. So I, for about 8 years, I was working as a cooperative developer, a worker-owned cooperative developer, primarily in Texas. I left and did some climate coalition work in the South Pacific. Bridging these two things together, figured that the space that was really needed in the US is work around non-human personhood. Sorry, the sounds. The space needed more work was around non-human personhood here in the US. Did a bunch of work around wild law, market dynamics, urban planning, environmental land use management, things like this, and came up with a few regions where I thought the work would be most impactful. And the Northeast, to me, is certainly that's the top of the list.
Great, great. So it makes a lot of sense to have you come to our conference when it's in the Northeast.
Yeah.
And, you know, we'll have lots of folks from the Northeast and from other parts of the country and around the world. But yeah, there's a lot of great work happening in the Northeast and really great that you're going to be a part of it. So I know biodynamics is not something that is like a long history that you have with, but how would you describe your experience relationship to biodynamics and maybe what you're curious about learning more at to the conference?
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm familiar with a lot of the philosophical tenets that have emerged, or not emerged, but coalesce in the practice of biodynamics. I was very unfamiliar with those who are practicing biodynamics, but since being asked to keynote, I've become a bit more familiar, and I'm really interested to learn more about how the practice has changed over the years, particularly as we've come to learn more and more about the non-human species around us. Particularly as we think about our role and our engagement as stewards in a time of climate crisis. So, yeah, I'm excited to learn more about the biodynamics.
Great. And what, I'm curious if there are any intersections you see between the work you've been doing and biodynamics.
Stewardship. Understandings, practices around stewardship, how it is that we go about redefining stewardship in these different times and what sort of traditions around stewardship we pass down to the next generations. I think those are the sites and the sites of intersection that I see most.
Great. Great. Yeah, that's something that we've really been thinking and talking a lot about in the Biodynamic Association. You know, we used to be called the Biodynamic Farming and Gardening Association, and we started expanding that, you know, farmers and gardeners and land stewards, and there's so many different ways to steward land, and I think, yeah, there's a lot of other practices we can learn from, and also a lot that biodynamics has to offer in terms of how we think about, you know, not just the cultivation of food crops, but, you know, how are we relating to the land more broadly.
Definitely. Yeah, and this is all going to be here present at the conference, huh? Some of it.
Yeah. So the theme of this year's conference is cultivating relationships, earth, cosmos, and community. And love to hear what resonates for you in that theme.
Yeah. I'm a big fan of these words thrown together in the way that they have been. So congrats to the people who managed that little moment of joy. Cultivating relationships, I think, is the basis of being an advocate and organizer around land sovereignty and climate responses. The fact that these things occur here on our planet and that our planet has a relationship with other planets, other spaces, conceptually and physically is a great source of refuge for me in these times. So I look forward to joining in community with others who are interested in experiencing that refuge or discussing other sorts of places.
Great, wonderful. And how do you see what you and Stephanie are bringing as your keynote duo in relationship to the theme of the conference?
I believe Stephanie and I are very interested in identifying relationships that need cultivation, need numbers of participants and numbers of minds thinking about how to cultivate these relationships. That's currently where we are as we go about renegotiating relationships, attempting to heal previous relationships, attempting to develop new ones. I think that her perspective as a healer and my perspective as a scholar in many respects is going to yield some really interesting insights and some potentially some really interesting discourse. So that's my thoughts.
Great. Yeah. I got to talk to her earlier today and she was talking about the dynamic that you have and she was talking about the seer and the healer and how that can really flow together. So I'm looking forward to seeing what you bring together to the opening of the conference.
Yeah, I'm excited.
Great. Well, is there, and then you guys are also doing a workshop. Do you want to share anything about the workshop that you're doing?
I am very excited about this workshop. Our messaging for the last 4 months and what we hope to continue for a time indeterminate, or at least a time until it's quite effectual, is 5 solutions for land-based wealth redistribution. That's the name of the workshop. And we're really going to be focusing on personhood for this workshop. We're really going to be focusing on ways in which here in the United States, work is being done to cultivate stronger relationships, and particularly ones that reduce some of the environmental degradation that we've encountered and reduce some of the psychological wounding that exists in these lands. So yeah, we're very excited. I'm very excited about the workshop in particular.
Great, wonderful. That would be great for people to have the opportunity to dig in a little bit deeper with what you have been working with. And great. Is there anything else that you'd like to share with folks who are interested in coming to the conference?
I don't bite. I'm very excited. I think it's going to be a wonderful opportunity. I'm pleased. I feel very welcomed and very comfortable to assume this small role and share some words and some thoughts and some skills. So
wonderful. Well, I'm so glad that you'll be coming, and encourage folks to check out biodynamics.com/conference to see everything that's going to be part of the conference. And yeah, looking forward to seeing you soon in New York.
Awesome. Sick. Thank you.
Thank you.